So today we're going to do a bit of a revival, not vice grip garage level. I'm not going to tell you that this hasn't run for 30 years and I'm going to drive it, you know, 634 miles home to Tennessee. But we might have to check the sparkulator and the lightning cans. It certainly needs a bit of oil, because whatever oil is on there is pretty gooped up. So we'll start off by just putting out a little bit. This engine has been, it's been very slightly tweaked. I put a tiny little switch here so that it only fires when it needs to, when the exhaust valve is in the correct place for it to need to fire. Otherwise, they go tick, 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 tick in the miss, which isn't the end of the world, but, you know, why waste the battery? I've also got a little magnet underneath the battery tray so that my Tiger Balm sits here. That's about it, really. Oh, look, I've changed the spring out for something else. So switch, spring, Tiger Balm. It looks like I probably changed the ignition point to top the center or very slightly after. But it hasn't run for a while. Just going to check the spark plug, and that's it. This is one of the ones with one of these green rings on it. I'm not entirely wrapped with that. I'd rather a copper ring. Oh my goodness, that's a mess. It's actually not that bad. A little bit of a mess, shall we say. I will give that a clean. It's just a little bit dark. I'm going to try the old toothbrush trick. So I'll just pop that in there. And oh yeah, that's what we're talking about. Yeah. So that spark plug really wasn't that bad. Probably would have worked fine. Okay. Now, one of the things you got to watch out with the hit and miss engines, the little ones in particular, is that the intake valve, which is an atmospheric valve, doesn't stick. That'll absolutely stop your engine working. I'm just going to blow this through a bit. I should use one of my glass syringes, shouldn't I, for this kind of thing, but it's going to be a good long run. These things run for ages because, you know, you get them ticking over slowly and my word, they run for a long time. There's quite a lot of fuel in that little tank under there. Must be full there, right? Yeah, I'd say that's full. Right. Stick the top on before I tip it over and leak everything everywhere. I guess I should check my batteries, but I'm going to check the batteries by actually starting the engine, which means I can't be asked. Yes, you heard it here first. I cannot be asked checking the batteries. Let's see what we've got. Do we have any pops? Did I do that up? Okay, should be good. We've got compression. Good compression. Right, now we've got to check to see whether we've actually got petrol coming through our line. Yep, whoa, that's great, great suction there. Oh, and we've got firing, so yeah, we've got, I mean, this is nearly going. Don't want to flood it though. Okay, now I need to, oh yeah, my I told you I had to check that valve, and that's working really well, that atmospheric intake valve. Now, let's just try that again. What have we got here? Okay. I really don't want to flood it, so I'm just leaning it up a wee bit. Complain about that. How long has that been? Listen to it. Okay, well, I leaned it up too much, obviously. Let's just try that a wee bit more. What a nice wee engine. Actually, that didn't come out of the miss cycle. So we need a little bit of oil and a little bit of. That clucking noise is not coming from this. There's a chicken outside my door. Let me just have a look at this. Hello, Mrs. Chicken. Well, you've gone all quiet now. She's obviously camera shy. Dear Mrs. White Chicken, what's going on? Really? You'd like some bread? Well, we might have some breadcrumbs for you here if you're lucky. I know, it's tough being a chicken in Christchurch, New Zealand. Here you go. Yeah, I know. Walk, doctor. Walk. Okay, I'll get back to my engine. This is a channel about engines, this YouTube channel. Not about chickens. Now, the typical thing that these things will do when you've been running them this long and you're just trying to dial it in is the battery will go dead and you won't realise and you'll think that it's something that you've just fiddled with. So watch out for that. Just riched it up quite a bit. You can hear quite a difference. But I'm wondering if it will go, die from over richness like it was before, whether it was just doing that when it was cold. Yeah, it has. Yep. It sort of collects the richness, saves it up, and then dies. So how to clean it from flooded, hold down the exhaust, run it backwards, run it frontwards, and if it starts, then the problem was it was flooded.